the previous video, you learned how to create superscope and how to create multicast scope. Join me on this video to learn how to create reservations. Let's start. Imagine you want to assign a static IP address to one of your servers or clients. You might think to manually assign the IP address. While this will work, you must remember to remove the manually allocated IP address from any DHCP server scope that contain that IP address, or add it to an exclusion range. Or you might potentially face IP conflicts. Your DHCP server might have already leased that static IP address to an existing client. By assigning it manually to a new client, your client will have IP conflict on the network. Also, if you ever decide to change that IP address, you must revisit the computer and manually change the address. Then add the IP back to the pool or remove it from the exclusion range. Now, think of having several computers that you might want to assign a static IP address. While this is technically possible, it will become practically unsustainable and very difficult as the number of computers with the manual static IP address increase. A DHCP reservation is a method you can use to allocate static IP addresses from a pool to a designated client. The advantage of this process is that 1. You don't need to exclude any IP addresses from your pool. 2. You will never need to revisit the computers to reconfigure the IP addresses. 3. You can centrally control all your manually assigned IP addresses. To create a reservation, you only need a reservation name. This is a name that identifies the reservation. We usually use the computer name. IP address. This is specific IP that you would like to assign to a computer. MAC address. MAC address or media access control is the physical address of the network interface of that client. And a description. Description is optional. You don't need to provide it. But it is best and it is recommended to provide a description to help you identify the reservations when the time goes by. There are several methods to obtain the MAC address of a client. For example, you can use ipconfig/all command. Also, you can use arp-a command to display a list of IP addresses and their associated MAC address. Before starting to create a reservation, let's take a quick look at the current status in our DHCP. We can see two computers have already received an IP address from this scope. There are no existing reservations, and we have a small pool of IP addresses with an exclusion range. In order to create the reservation, right-click on Reservation and select New Reservation. On the open window, provide a name for your reservation. This is a name that identifies a reservation. It is recommended to use the computer name, but it is not necessary. Enter the desired IP address. This is the specific IP address that you would like to assign to computer. In this example, I'm using 192.168.48.240. Enter the MAC address or the physical address of the client network interface. If you don't know the MAC address, you can find it with several methods. Let's switch to our client and check. In run, type ncpa.cpl to open network connections. Right-click on your network adapter and select status. On the opened window, click details, and as you can see in this page, you can find the MAC address in the physical address field. Or from start menu, search for CMD and open command prompt. Type ipconfig/all and hit enter. System will return the details of the IP configuration and you can find the MAC address in physical address field. Copy this address and paste it in the MAC address field for reservation. Optionally, enter a description and hit enter. You can now see the reservation is added and the IP is receiving the options from the scope. We will talk about the options in future videos. Now let's check the results on our client. Initially, this computer had received 192.168.48.240 192.236. Open the command prompt and type ipconfig/release. This command will release the existing assigned IP address. Please note, you do not need to repeat this step every time. This is only one-time action to speed up the process for this demo. If you restart the computer, or if you restart the network adapter, the IP would be changed automatically, and you would not need to run the command. Now, if you look at the network connections again, you will notice the Ethernet has released the IP address and does not have any IP. Back in your command prompt, type ipconfig/renew to force the computer to reach out to the DHCP server and request a new IP. Now you notice the computer has received the new IP address that we reserved in the previous step, 192.168.48.240. If you go back to your DHCP and refresh the console, you can see that your computer has received the new IP address and it is visible under the reservations. You can also reserve an existing leased IP address. Simply open the address list section in the DHCP console, select the computer you want to reserve the IP for, right-click on the client IP address, and select Add to Reservation. This action will reserve the currently assigned IP address to that client. If you ever needed to delete a reserved IP, simply right-click on the reserved IP under the reservation and select Delete. Finally, confirm the action by clicking Yes. This will delete the reservation and client will receive the next available IP address from the scope. To create a reservation by PowerShell, open PowerShell as administrator, get the list of commands with the word reservation in them, type get -command *reservation*. Optionally, you can use get -help to see the syntax for your command. Type get -help add -DHCP server v4 reservation and hit enter. If you notice, you will see you only need to provide IP, MAC address, and the scope ID. Now, let's get the list of existing scopes by typing get -DHCP server v4 scope. To add the reservation, type add -DHCP server v4 reservation /scope ID and enter the network ID of your desired scope, -IP address, enter your desired IP address that you would like to reserve, -name, put your client's name in quotes, -client ID, and put your client MAC address in quotes. Hit enter. For this demo, I'm using 192.168.48.245. If you open your DHCP server and refresh the console, you can see your new reservation is in the reservation page. Lastly, if you go back to the client and renew the IP again, you will notice system will receive the newly reserved IP address. Open command prompt as administrator, release the IP by typing ipconfig/release, and then renew it by typing ipconfig/renew. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Join me on the next videos to learn a deeper knowledge on scope options, learn how to provide high availability to your DHCP server, and many more. See you on the next video.